know the rest that we pray and ask you to have 14 people be killed in the month of February, and you did that. We know that we have people that cry out to us. So God, we pray that you would touch so that you would heal, that you would deliver, and that you would set free. Indeed, God, we pray that on Easter Sunday, that 200 people walk behind and say, with those, but I can see it still all over the land of Kentucky, that there is a great turning back to you, that our hearts are turned back to you. Now, be our teacher and our preacher, bless us as we go forward in our lesson tonight, get all the glory in Jesus' name, amen. Elijah, it is our 7:15, and now we're going to finish tonight. Thank you. find out what the next people are doing. The Bible was written in three different languages. Does anybody know what they are? Hebrew, Greek, and Aramaic was on the board, so that you can have it written down on your notes correctly. Aramaic. You know what they talk in their neighborhood.
Because when the
hear me? And so what I have to go to the cross is this is the last words you uttered. My God, why has God forsaken me? And you uttered them in his own tongue. They thought that these words were too sacred to even translate. Therefore, they left him in Aramaic. But then they gave up the interpretation of what it meant. Because if you were reading your Bible, if you were reading that Jesus was hanging on the cross, and he said, Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani, now, you wouldn't know what that meant. Are you telling me? Now, I think, could you imagine if the whole Bible would be in this language? If the whole Bible were in this language, you would not be so from now to Mark chapter 5, Mark chapter 5. I think it would be this kind of wonderful that I'm looking to Mark, and this is my morning Bible reading. I've been planning on starting this. I'm using this morning in my evening Bible reading. Look at Mark chapter 5, verse 21. He took the devil back in the hand and said to her, Talitha, which is being interpreted what? Therefore, I said to thee, right, the reason, for whatever reason, God knows the reason for the heart of the dead man, it was too sacred to be translated. Did they have a Bible 5 years after Jesus died? Thank you. Thank you. 1609 to 1604, King James commissioned 50 of England's best known linguists and professors and theologians, and for 7 years, he charged them with the responsibility to write of the Bible. The Aramaic version of the Bible. And you write, listen to this, I'm very careful, in our own language, not only in English, but in the English language of that time. That's why you got the therefore and the thou and the thee, because that's how they spoke at that time. King James says, write a Bible. Give it word for word. Whatever they say in Greek, we might say it word in English. But just put it in our language. I'm with you here. And that's how in 1600 we got the Bible is called the King James Version. That's why it's the King James Version, because James, the King of England, commissioned its translation. And in 1611, it finally was finished with the book called the King James Version. Did anybody just learn anything? Did anybody just? Yeah, that's a good word. That's a good word, somebody from our department. That's a good word, said somebody from our department. I'm not worried that somebody is not fully terrified. I'm just thinking of you terrified of me. And it's just about to be the first day to translate the Bible from Latin to English. But it's not about to be the Bible. The Bible is not about to be the Bible. What was the Bible to be the Bible? So you don't work to know that you can just go through the English translation has given the King James Version. That is the next thing that you write right before all of the books start to appear. The most popular translation of the Bible has been the King James Version. Written in what year? 1611. And it's written in the dialect or in the language of the Old English. Now, Jesus did not necessarily speak using the King James language. Same, that's how it is. That's some of the language that people spoke at the time. Are you with me so far? Is anybody confused? Is anybody confused? I just want to know. Is anybody confused? Is this clear? I'm doing my best to make something complicated. Very clear. The King James Version, this is what you're saying. The King James Version of the Bible. 1611. The King James Version of the Bible. Has been from that day up to this day the most popular selling book in the history of the world. The most popular book in the history of the world is not 50 Shades of Grey. The most popular selling book in the history of the world is the King James Version of the Bible. From then until now, it is still the most popular book in the whole world. Listen, y'all, I know the people watching on TV, if we go off the line, I don't know why you need to switch over to the internet, hbcoc.org, click on TV, and then you'll get the last little empty portion. If you don't get the last little empty portion, you need to call Mr. Gordon McTeague. I'm trying to go on TV.
Thank you.
international version came along, abbreviation is NIV. The NIV. You need an 8-grade reading level to understand the NIV. Once you finish writing, look up. But if you really don't have it,
thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. If you want to be a part of